Let's begin the new chapter in political science, that is working of institution. Here in this module we are going to understand following topics.
Objective of this module are the process taking major policy, where we will understand the government order and the need of political institution.
In democracy, rulers have to work with institution or with an institution. These institutions meet across together and take important decisions for the growth of country. So what are these institutions? Basically, these institutions are the pillar of government, and these are executive, legislative and judiciary. Here in this module, we are going to understand the combined effort of all these three institutions.
Working of institutions. Let us look first, why do we need political institutions in a country? We need them for following reasons. A government have to perform various duties, formulate policies and implement them. Some have to formulate schemes, some have to take decisions and some have to implement those decisions. The constitution lays down basic rules, powers and functions of each institutions. These institutions are legislative or the parliament, executives or the government, judiciary, that is the legal system. Parliament is needed as to final authority to make the law in a country. Parliament exercises the control over the working government. Parliament controls the expenditure of government and controls the public money. As a highest forum of debate and discussion, it decides the public issues and national policies. Two houses of parliament are there in India, the Lok Sabha and the Rajya Sabha. The Lok Sabha has the elected representatives and is the house of people, whereas the Rajya Sabha is the elected by the elected ministers of each state assembly and is also called the Council of Ministers or the government. The President, the Prime Minister and his Council of Ministers and civil servants form the executives. The political executives consist of political leaders elected by the people, who act on their behalf and are responsible for the public who elected them. They take all the decisions and act accordingly. The Prime Minister has three kinds of ministers who help him in doing their work. One is the Cabinet Ministers, second is the Minister of States, and third is the Deputy Ministers. The Prime Minister position is the supreme one. He chooses his cabinet and his decision remains the final, except in the coalition government. In coalition government, he has to listen to the other party government as well. When Prime Minister quits, the entire ministry used to quit. The President exercises all his legislative, executive, financial, judiciary and military powers only at the advice of Prime Minister and his Council of Ministers. The President can only delay the bill. If Parliament passes it, he has to sign it again. The judiciary. The Indian judiciary is one of the most powerful judiciary in the world. The judiciary is an independent body. Once the appointment of the judges is being done, then they can be removed only by the impeachment movement. The Supreme Court and the High Court have the power to interrupt the Constitution. It can declare only the law passed by the legislature as invalid if it violates the Constitution. It safeguards the fundamental rights of the people of India and it checks the malpractices and misuse of powers by the executives and legislatives. In short, is the working of institution in the government of India.
Process of taking major decision policy. Children, this process of making major policy decision passes through the government order. Here we need to understand what is government order. You might have seen in school several circular used to pass where we might have observed the signature of principal or the authority. In the same manner, issuing of office order used to pass through with the written matter and undersigned by the government or the authority, which sometimes is also called as the office memorandum. Now, after issuing the office memorandum or the office order, sometime a controversy used to take place among public. People do not give their support and they don't want to see the implementation of this government order. For that, they used to put their opinion in front of media and then it became a big controversy or the protest. For that, the intervening of High Court or the Supreme Court also used to take place. They used to check whether it is following the constitutional way or not, and then they saw their validity. Along with that, they used to modify and then they used to permit that office order. In this way, we have seen what is office order and how does this pass. Under the process of taking major decision policy, children, now we need to understand who are these decision makers. These are Prime Minister, President and Parliament. Let us understand what are their role. President is the head of the state and is the highest authority in the country. And Prime Minister is the head of the government and used to take most of the important decision in his cabinet meeting. He actually governs the governmental powers. And now comes the Parliament. Parliament consists of two major bodies. One is President, another is the combination of Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Lok Sabha is also called as the lower house where the representatives are elected by the common people. And Rajya Sabha used to work for the favor of states and union territories. So in this manner, these three plays very important role in making important decisions. That's all in this module, dear children. Remaining topic we are going to understand in upcoming module. Till then, stay happy, stay safe.
Let us do some questionnaire. Prime Minister is one who actually exercises all governmental power and he is the head of the government, parliament, council member or Rajya Sabha. Next question is, name the two houses of the parliament, Janata Sabha and Rajya Sabha, Bhajpa Sabha or Lok Sabha, or Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, or none of these. Last question is, the President of India is the highest formal authority in district, state, union or city. Answer all these questions in comment. Thank you for watching.